behind the mask, hiding the hurt, hiding the pain, hiding the tears that fall like rain, saying I'm fine when I'm anything but. This ache in my soul rips at my gut. My skin is on fire, I burn from within. The calm on my face is an ongoing sin. The world must stay out, I've built up a wall. My fragile lie will collapse should it ever fall. Loneliness consumes me, it eats away the years, until my life is swallowed by unending fears. Wanting for someone to see I wear a mask and care enough to remove it, is that too much to ask?
Good afternoon, teachers, students, staff, and Director Ribeiro. My name is Kevin Gonzalez, and welcome to my senior talk. What you just experienced was an interpretation of what a person going through depression feels like. Depression. What is depression? Depression is a feeling of sadness, a feeling of hopelessness and despair. An unknown person once wrote, depression, it's like drowning, except you can see everyone around you breathing. Like depression, therapy is also seen as taboo, with many people believing it's for the weak, or it's a waste of money. I understand that therapy is seen with skepticism, but I want to help people realize that therapy is a good thing, and it works fairly well for a lot of people. My peer Miguel created a support group. However, I wanted to teach the science about depression through the Know the Science campaign in California. After teaching people the science, I offered them the way for help. I would like to share with you the story of my depression and anxiety, because I know how hard it is to open up to others. And I'd like to inspire you to break out of your silence and seek help if this is you. The bullying started in sixth grade. I was a short brown kid with a really high-pitched voice and a really strange accent. Soon kids started calling me names, making fun of my voice and my accent. They would mimic me and laugh. I was a big kid, about 180 pounds by the age of 12. People would say things like, why are you so fat? Over the years, I tried to put up walls to fortify myself. I would stop eating for days at a time to try and lose weight. I would stop talking so that people wouldn't have to hear me speak. This made my depression spike. I found myself not wanting to do anything, not wanting to eat, not wanting to sleep, not wanting to go out or hang out with friends. I felt like it was just a thing that would go away shortly. Days would go by as if they were minutes. Every day just seemed like a task that I needed to get over with and restart the next day. I had lost my will to live. And I had thought about suicide every night for weeks. No one noticed. I would walk around with a big smile on my face, hiding the frown that laid upon my soul, and I told myself that if I couldn't go on with suicide, maybe I should try to talk to someone. This is when one of my teachers started noticing that I was writing about suicidal thoughts and feeling depressed. She guided me to my counselor. There, I reached out to my counselor, and she appointed me to a therapist. After a few weeks with the therapist, I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety. The therapist suggested that I start taking antidepressants. But ladies and gentlemen, antidepressants have the connotation of being happy pills. But I'm here to share with you that antidepressants are more than just pills. I started exercising with friends. I changed my eating habits. I hung out with my family more, and played with my little sisters. And I even tried new things, like volleyball. These antidepressants are what saved my life. Together with the support, with therapy and the support of my friends and family. I would like to share with you a video of my service learning project, of me teaching in classrooms the science of depression from the Know the Science campaign. Please enjoy. Knowing the science and spreading awareness is extremely important in order to change the perspective of this topic. I met up with people who I noticed were having a bad day. And after teaching them the science, what I discovered was that these people are willing to open up if you're willing to start a conversation with them. They would tell me about their struggles. They would tell me about their feelings. They would tell me about what goes on at home and how they deal with their depression. This is important to me because I know what it feels like to feel this way. Being depressed and not knowing how to ask for help. I no longer feel anxious for no reason. I no longer feel scared over nothing. I no longer feel sad for no reason. Instead, I now feel sad about things that I feel are sad. Instead of feeling anxious all the time, I now feel anxious about things like going up in percentage. That dark cloud that was hanging above my head all day suddenly stopped following me around. And this? I don't need this anymore. I'm much happier now. I would like to teach you all some of the signs of depression from the Know the Science campaign. Through these thought-provoking images. Withdrawal. When a person isolates themselves, like if you have a friend that used to hang out all the time, but all of a sudden they don't hang out anymore. Increased alcohol and drug use. People with depression often seek drugs and alcohol as a way to escape reality. Suicidal thoughts. People with depression have persistent thoughts about leaving this earth that just won't go away. Hopelessness. The feeling you get when you feel like trying isn't getting you anywhere. Anxiety. Depressives often feel like the world is out to get them. Anxiety feels like When you lean back on your chair a little too far, and you feel like you're falling, but instead of falling for half a second, it could last for years. Behavioral changes. People with depression often start behaving differently. Like if you have a friend that likes soccer a lot, and all of a sudden they don't seem interested anymore. People with depression often struggle with either sleeping too much or sleeping too little. This can affect their daily mood. I took on the challenge of educating my community about the signs of depression through the Know the Signs campaign. I like to know the signs as mental first aid, because anyone can learn the signs and anyone can help a person get help. Some of the people I help are now doing better. Some of the people I taught are now doing better because they are now going to therapy. They can now function without having to. They can now function without having to worry about living another day. What I mean by this is that they don't have to deal with this on their own anymore. They have someone there to help them. You don't need to go through life alone. This project has changed the way I am, because teaching and helping others has given me the happiness and confidence to ask, what's wrong? I have made new friends along the way, and I have learned about people's struggles. This has changed my perspective on how a small problem becomes a big problem when left unnoticed. Often a person doesn't know anything's wrong until everything's wrong. I challenge you to help a person out to spread awareness about what depression is really like. You may have seen people wearing these pins. What they signify is that they know the signs and they can now teach it to someone else. Like paying it forward. I want my community to know that help is always available and to know the signs of depression. A healthy community is an informed community that knows the signs and knows how to help someone get help, because there is help. Thank you.